Hi and welcome to the plugin autopsy of Shadow Studio, which is the curly-haired stepchild of all the plugin everything plugins, which has been banished to the barrens of Video Hive, and that's where it currently resides. So, what is Shadow Studio? Well, in 2014, I was playing around with the drop shadow effect, which we all know and love inside After Effects. And the drop shadow effect has a softness slider. And I was thinking, oh, okay, cool. Let's make some soft shadows with this. And you crank up the softness, but all it is just blurs the whole layer and doesn't look very good. The goal was to make it look like soft shadows in real life. Often in computer graphics, these are done via a very slow process called ray tracing. And we'll have some graphics on the screen which show you these beautiful ray trace shadows. But the problem with that is they're very expensive. With ray trace shadows, these are generally based on geometry. And I wanted to create shadows based on essentially the alpha of your layer. That means, you know, you can use it on 2D layers. You don't have to have the text being extruded in 3D. So that's where the advantage of the drop shadow comes in. So what I did was duplicated the drop shadow, and for every copy of the drop shadow that I duplicated, I made it a little bit softer and a little bit more transparent. And when you rack up, say, 32 drop shadows, the result is actually really beautiful. And so I bundled this up into a preset called Faux Ray Traced Shadows, which also lives on Video Hive and has done so since 2014. I was really happy with the results of this preset. We'll show the preview video. The results look beautiful, if I can say so myself. The issue is that you have 32 drop shadows and that's quite inefficient. When I learned how to make plugins, I thought this would be a great candidate to speed up the process or try and make it a bit more efficient, as well as I can add more features in, because if anyone who's made a preset knows, presets are based on effects and you can't then add additional features into the effects because I didn't make the inbuilt drop shadow effect. So was very limited with what the drop shadow can do. So, but when you're making a plugin, you can add as many features as you want. And so I thought, this is cool. Let's basically just make the same thing. The idea was just to make the Faux Ray Trace Shadow preset, but as a plugin, it's gonna be more efficient, it's gonna be faster, and then we can add some more features. I think I failed on the making it faster front because the plugin is still really slow. I just noticed that because normally I'm working on a desktop, especially when I was building this plugin, I was working on a desktop, and you know, desktops are much faster than laptops. And then I had to update it the other day and I was working on it on my laptop and it was so slow that I thought this isn't even worth using. So definitely room for improvement on the speed. It hasn't really been updated since 2017, but I'm looking at updating it, maybe shifting it to the GPU, because the GPU is an ideal candidate for doing all these very expensive or very repetitive blurring operations that is being done under the hood. I'd love to update it. I'd love to add in new features, such as you tell me what features you want, because I don't know, and port it to the GPU to make it faster. But let's talk about the features it does have. So when I was building this plugin, this was around the time of the long shadow epidemic, where everyone was adding these long shadow presets to their graphics, and sometimes people still use them. I think they kind of look cool, but they were certainly done to death. That's just one of the many looks that this, that's why it's called Shadow Studio. It creates many different types of shadows. So it creates soft shadows, long shadows, radial shadows, inner shadows, and shadow shadows. So five different types of shadows. The type that I'm particularly proud of is the radial shadows. So with the normal drop shadow, the light source is based on a direction, which is just the angle slider. But with a radial shadow, the light is based on a point in 2D space, X and Y. And based on the origin, think of it as an anchor point. Each sample of the shadow has its anchor point, bases that origin, and gets a little bit larger each time. So it gets a little bit larger and a little bit softer, and that creates this really cool effect that you have a point light and you have these beautiful soft shadows based off this point light. Another feature we have is the inner shadow. which frankly ought to be implemented into the default drop shadow, but I guess there is the layer style in a shadow, so maybe you don't need that. But essentially what this does is it takes a stencil of the layer and uses that to generate shadows and then mats the result of that to your current layer. And so that creates this cool effect where the shadow is being generated inside your layer, and that creates some really cool stylistic effects. That's kind of where Shadow Studio is at the moment. Overall, my thoughts on this plugin is it creates beautiful results very slowly with a quite unintuitive user interface. It was very intuitive to me because I built it and I know exactly how to use it, but I imagine that someone who picked up this plugin and was trying to get good results would probably have to fiddle around. So definitely in the next version, I'll be working on making the controls more intuitive, more user-friendly, and as well as desperately increasing the speed of the plugin to make it usable. That's it for Shadow Studio. Check it out if you dare to visit videohive.com. There's some cool stuff there, but there's mostly a lot of, let me rephrase that. There are some gems in the rough in Video Hive. That's it. Buy Shadow Studio and wait for the update that will never come.